the Muskegon River Watershed, which is what we're in right now, it goes into Muskegon Lake, which goes into Lake Michigan. It's all part of the Great Lakes Basin. And so in 2018, the Muskegon Conservation District submitted and received a U.S. Forest Service Great Lakes Restoration Initiative grant to install green infrastructure in the Muskegon River Watershed. I worked with the County Drain Commissioner to choose these locations next to the county drains that need trees the most. This area had recently been revetted. There's been a new project to control the stream banks here, and so a lot of trees have to be cut down. When trees get cut down in the areas along drains, then sometimes you lose a lot of the sediment. When there's sediment that enters the water bodies, that decreases the quality of the water. The tree roots are going to hold the soil better and create less erosion, and so that's why she chose this location. In the other location, there's no trees at all along the Holland Drain. So the Drain Commissioner had decided that that was the best spot for these trees.
Not many people think of the benefits of trees and what they can do to the environment, or even that it is a type of green infrastructure that cities could be using. Part of the green infrastructure is capturing all the nutrients from parking lots. It's taking in some of the fertilizer before it enters the stream. Once people see the benefits, they might place a tree on their property to help more of the canopy coverage that we need.
After a few months of planning and figuring out where all the trees were going to go, in 2019 we did our first tree planting. We had planted 2,000 seedlings at an area down the drain, and then 220 of these large trees.
We have tamarack, birch, white cedar, oak species, and maple species as well.
These trees will reduce 50,000 gallons of stormwater runoff per year. In 5 years, it should reduce 241,950 gallons of stormwater runoff. So it's going to add to the water quality because there's less water entering the system. In addition, once these trees mature, the tree canopy will shade out these areas. A lot of issues that we have with water quality right now is thermal pollution. And that is when there isn't tree canopy over the streams. A lot of streams here in Michigan are cold water streams that are providing habitat for things such as trout and other cold water fisheries. They're very sensitive to different temperatures. So once the thermal pollution happens and the water increases, those fish aren't going to be able to be sustainable. Once these trees get bigger, not as much sunlight will be touching the stream. Once that starts cooling down the water, it will have a lot of benefits towards that as well. Following the planting of the trees, we staked the trees, and were a little wobbly, and then we installed these water bags. And then since then, we've been checking periodically, watering every 1 to 2 weeks. The goal eventually is to just have these trees be here. We are going to pull some of the tree guards and the water bags, and then now that they've been given a really good head start, I'm hoping that they will be here for years to come, and we hope to do many more projects with the Forest Service and work together to achieve larger goals for the overall watershed and Great Lakes.